Oh, my 2020 travel year in review. I've been looking forward to this. So what was it like in 2020? Well, I would say it was essentially a dumpster fire. That's what I would call it. This entire multi-billion dollar travel business essentially went out of business in less than 9 months. Why? Because we were all at home trying to figure out how to log into our children's online school platforms. That's why. Now, listen, if you think I am making fun of the millions of people directly or indirectly affected physically, emotionally, or financially by the coronavirus, then you need to stop watching this video right now because you don't know me very well. I am absolutely heartbroken at these circumstances. I own my own business and I travel for a living promoting how wonderful it is to travel. Hotels, they went out of business. Shop owners closed their lifelong dreams. Resorts shuttered, restaurants stopped serving. Airlines stopped flying, cruise ships stopped sailing. Beach towns were empty. A lot of people lost their job because the entire travel infrastructure was crushed under the weight of regulation, reality, and fear, much like my bathroom scale. That's another video. What makes 2020 worse is that it was right after 2019. Now, that was one of the best years in travel and tourism, but the foundation was beginning to crack long before the pandemic. You see, we started to hear whispers of too many people in Venice because of the cruise ships. You know, really? It's that expensive to go to Walt Disney World? Are you kidding me? My ass is wider than the seat I bought in coach. Tainted booze in Mexico. All the crappy dog food I can eat at an all-inclusive. And don't think, we did participate in this too. You know, we took those trips. And some people, not you, of course, they got kicked off airplanes for fighting. They got drunk and fell overboard on cruise ships, littered in national parks, trashed hotel rooms, went off-roading in a Nissan Sentra rental. They claimed their precious dog was a service animal. They tried to game the system. You see my point here? So it takes two to tangle. But the good news is 2021 is just around the corner. And I have dedicated my entire life to travel. I gladly made that decision back in 2006. And frankly, I couldn't be more excited for what's on the horizon. Because like the phoenix rising from the ashes, travel will return bigger, stronger, and better than ever. Travel as we know it is dead. So long. Enjoy the holiday season. Let's buckle up for a fantastic 2021 in travel.